Rush is the greatest band of all time.
How can three guys make such a sound?
Yet to be inducted in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, is there any chance your next album will be called That's Bullshit?
Sincere and honest. It's also really good, you know? That matters more than anything else.
My name is Dave Grohl.
I'm Taylor Hawkins.
And we are here tonight to induct Rush into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Rock and roll has forever been ensconced in mystery. Robert Johnson selling his soul to the devil that early morning that Satan knocked upon his door. The death of Paul McCartney in 1966 and the conspiracy to replace him with an exact lookalike. Elvis sightings, Jim Morrison sightings, Axl Rose sightings. But there's one mystery that surely eclipses them all. When the fuck did Rush become cool? It was 1976 when my cool older stoner cousin gave me my first copy of 2112. Upon first inspection, I was fascinated by the track listing. The entire side one of the album was a seven-part suite with Roman numerals and names like the Temples of Syrinx. And Oracle, the Dream. This was far from my Kiss records with such great works of literature like Love Gun and Ladies' Room. No, this was something else. This was heavy shit. And then I saw what is perhaps the most infamous band photo of all time. Three grown men, arms crossed, standing proudly in white satin kimonos and skin-tight pants. Yeah. How skin tight, you ask? So skin tight that you can still find the one, the only guitar god, Alex Lifeson, on cameltoe.org.
But what was inside is why we are here today. Yeah. Geddy Lee's ripping bass, his incredible, unmistakable voice. Alex Lifeson's soulful, imaginative, melodic, chaotic guitar solos. And of course, fucking Neil Peart. God, come on! This guy spawned a generation of air drummers for decades to come. With his composition, craft, and technique, his drumming was songwriting. It was just as musical, just as melodic as any other instrument in the band, bringing the drums where they fucking should be, to the forefront of every song. But here's the thing about Neil Peart. Not only was he the most fucking ripping drummer in the world, he wrote the fucking lyrics. Who let the fucking drummer write the lyrics? Rush did, baby. Makes no sense.
Playing upwards of 250 shows a year, from day one, the band built its following the right way. No hype, no bullshit. They did it from the ground up. Without any help from the mainstream press.
Rolling Stone.
Rush, Fly By Night, Caress of Steel, 2112, A Farewell to Kings, Hemispheres, Permanent Waves, Moving Pictures, Signals, Grace Under Pressure, Power Windows, Hold Your Fire, Presto, Roll the Bones, Counterparts, Test for Echo, Vapor Trails, Feedback, Snakes and Arrows, Clockwork Angels, 45 years, over 40 million records, thousands of shows, selling out arenas all over the world. Their influence is undeniable, and their devoted fan base only rivaled by the Grateful Dead. Look at you people right there, all of you right there. And their legacy is that of a band that stayed true to themselves no matter how uncool they may have seemed to anyone. I think it's safe to say that Rush are indeed a band that has balls.
Yeah! Alex showed us that.
Yeah. And they've always been cool. So consider this mystery solved. It is our honor to finally induct Rush into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
We've been saying for a long time, years, that this wasn't a big deal. Turns out, it kind of is. Our sincere, heartfelt thanks to Dave and Taylor for doing us the great honor of inducting us. Theirs is truly the praise of the praiseworthy. Maybe one day, we will be inducting them. I've always liked a quote from Bob Dylan. The highest purpose of art is to inspire. What else can you do for anyone but inspire them? It is gratifying to think of us having inspired these youngsters to pick up a pair of drumsticks, a guitar, a rhyming dictionary, and torment their parents as we tormented ours. All the previous inductees into this pantheon of rock are like a constellation of stars in the night sky. Among them, we are one tiny point of light, shaped like a maple leaf. Around each star swirls a galaxy, in our case, a galaxy of families. The families that raised us, elevated us, and now the families that ground us. Those who remain and those who are gone. Then there is the family of people around us who take care of business, day after day, deal after deal, dime after dime. Like our manager throughout all this, Ray Daniels. Then there is the family of people who truly put on the show, for it is fitting that we receive this honor as a working band in the middle of a tour in our 39th year. We should always stay 39. I speak of the road crews, the technicians, the engineers, and co-producers, our friends and family, and these guys.
Thank you guys so much. I have to say this is a little overwhelming for a nice Jewish boy from Toronto. I've been really fortunate in my life to be able to spend my time doing something that I truly love to do, and to do it with two really terrific partners. That makes it all the sweeter. And so I'd like to thank Lurks and Pratt over here, not only for the privilege of making music together with them, but for the great pleasure of their mostly hilarious company for the past four decades. And on behalf of my two partners, I have to thank the most passionate, most dedicated, incredible fan base around the globe. That's you guys, for not only supporting and encouraging our musical progress over the years, but for the insistence of their voices, which has most certainly led us to this evening. Yeah! We share this honor with you. Thank you.
Blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. Blah 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 blah, blah. Blah, blah. Blah, blah. Blah, blah.
We'll be right back. designs. opportunity on the studio wall.
We'll be right back. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
I told you, man. Dude, can we just talk about something? How amazing is Rush?
Excuse me. How amazing is Rush?
Amazing.
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 I was like, oh my God. Red Barchetta?
Come on.
How does Geddy still hit those high notes?
Voice of an angel.
I swear to God, he must drink a lot of tea.
Totes.
Hey, do you think it's cool to be in here? We're the only ones.
Pete, all access passes. That means we can go anywhere.
Maybe it was a mistake to bring the Dubloneck.
Are you kidding me? Once they sign that, that's gonna be a memento for the rest of your life.
Dude, we are in Rush's green room.
No kidding. Happy birthday, hombre.
Thank you, my brosian. You know, tickets to Rush and backstage passes, best gift ever.
Dude, you're worth it.
Uh-oh, I'm going to eat you a sandwich.
Hey, that says for Neil only. I wouldn't eat that.
That sign is for, like, roadies and stuff, okay? And besides, the Holy Trinity, that guy's just like us. Except they're also the greatest musicians in the history of the world.
I saw four in the mezzanine.
Yeah, I had three in the front row.
Seven females at a Rush concert. Must be some kind of a world record. Whoa.
Hey, who are you guys?
We, have the laminate. We have the laminates. We thought it was okay to just come in here, but we can totally get out of your hair if you need
fine.
Us to.
We're it's, fine. We're fine. It's fine. Hi, guys. Hello. How do you do? My name is Sidney Fife, and this is my man, Peter Klavan.
Hello.
And we're just the biggest Rush fans in the history of the planet Earth.
The biggest. Right.
Again.
Because we would do these Rush jam sessions in my man cave.
Your what?
Oh, that's my garage. I'm sorry. You guys should totally come hang out sometime. It's just like guys being guys. We jam out. Yeah. We hang out. I have a jerk-off station.
You know, the first song that we ever jammed out to was Tom Sawyer.
Yeah.
And we couldn't do the drums. No one can do the drums like you. What we did is like...
What did you call that song?
Oh, I know it's called Tom Sawyer, but I love it in the song when you go, modern day warrior, mean stride, today's Tom Sawyer, mean pride.
I don't think I say it like that.
No, I'm pretty sure you say Tom Sawyer.
Hey, is that my sandwich?
Sidney. I told you not to eat Mr. Peart's sandwich.
It's just Peart.
You sure that it's not Peart?
I think he would know.
Are you sure? Because we're pretty big fans.
Chill, man. Look, guys, it's been a long night.
Oh, tote. Mug-out. I just gotta say, though, before I go, that was such a sweet-ass set. I was like, oh, freaking out. And the whole moving pace. Right, and then with the when you were playing the drums, is that hard?
Yes, it's hard.
Guys, you gotta go now. All right, now.
Yeah.
No.
Let's get out of their head.
They're jamming. Hold on, guys. Listen, it's my friend's birthday today, so I got him tickets to your concert, which are not cheap, by the way. We grew our show beards just for you. So the least you could do is sign my friend's nine string.
You got a double neck? Do you know how to play that thing?
Not nearly as good as you, but I have been known to slap the bass big time.
Why is he talking like a leprechaun?
Everybody says that. No, it's my it's like a Caribbean. It's like my Rasta guy. It's like a da beer simmon.
Hey, can I check your laminate there, dude?
Whoa, it's legit leaflet. It's all access.
Hey, Dirk, check this out.
Mm-hmm.
Is this a fake or what?
3 C's in access? Come on.
You told me your buddy Ethan worked at the record label.
My buddy Ethan works at Kinko's.
I'm gonna get someone to come down here and kick your ass unless you get out of here now.
I think we understand when we're not wanted.
Finally.
Thank you for the sandwich.
No, leave it.
Go, well, guys.
I've already taken a bite.
So sorry, Rush.
There's no Dirk and Rush.
That's a nickname, like Jobin. Go. Well,
who carries around a walkie-talkie?
Sorry, Rush. Why? Why did you fake the laminate?
I'm sorry. Okay, I really am. I wanted your birthday to be special.
I know, but now Rush thinks we're idiots.
Hey, Peter, you forgot something. Happy birthday, man. You keep slapping that bass.
Oh my God, they signed it. They all signed it. Oh my God. I think we made a real impression on those guys.
Of course they signed it. What did I tell you? Peter, the Holy Triumvirate, they're regular guys just like us.